All right, boys and girls, today I'm doing a video. This is a SoundCubed S1-1250, I think it is. Let's see what that thing says. Yeah, S1-1250. These are kind of crazy expensive right now because SoundCubed decided to go to a dealer format and they don't quite offer the deals they used to. But anyway, this is a great amp. It's $1,250. I think the thing, somebody dynoed it or whatever. I think it does well overrated. And these come with these, you know, it's the entry level model, I guess. They come with the basic RCAs. And I thought, you know, these Tiffany style, and these are Chinese crap, whatever. But the chassis mount looks so much better, and they can't be more than, what did I get these things for? 20 pieces for $10. So if I bought that on Amazon, you know, it's not going to cost them that much. And while they're building the thing, you know, why not put them in there? It's, you know, a few minutes and a few dollars. But anyway, here is you know, the ones that came out. So you've got, this is the double, and this is where it's soldered to the board. The two front, look at it like this. If you're looking at the board, this top left and top right are both grounds. The top left is for the bottom RCA. The bottom left is the positive for the bottom RCA. Top left is the ground. Same thing for the tabs on the right. The top right is the ground for the top RCA. The bottom right is the hot for the top RCA. And that's for the left and right. And this was for the, this particular one had the master slave input, output, whatever, so you can strap them. And same deal. That was mounted like so on the board. The upper one is the ground, and you can test that with your voltmeter or continuity meter, ohm meter, whatever. The top one is ground, the bottom one is hot. And you see on the back side here, that strap is the hot, and then hot being the center of the RCA. The outside is the ground. So that's where I'd pulled them out, and they're soldered. I took that end plate out, and you see this is where I put the new panel mount, chassis mount in the plate. That's where the left and right. So let me see if I can get something to point. Okay, that's ground on the bottom, that's hot on the bottom RCA, that's ground on the top, and that's hot on the top. Under the board here, if you take an iron, which I think this is still turned on, with the sharp tip, the pencil tip, this is a 35 watt iron with a pencil tip. And usually what I'll do is put the iron, let me get this lid back up, warm it up a little bit on the top side, then go, you know, you'll have to hold the amp up and down so you can get in between the board and the heatsink. And you might even add a little bit of solder, just a touch, to get it to flow. And you warm a little bit this and a little bit that and a little bit this and a little bit that, and lift up on it, and, you know, keep a little pressure on it, it'll pop up very gently because you don't want to crack the board. Then you warm this one up and warm this one up, and back and forth, and you'll feel it lift up. And then you go back to here and back and forth, back and forth. So it's back and forth like that, and it'll pop out. And as you can see in this picture, I still got a little solder in there, and that's okay. So let's go to same thing on that side. That was the slave, if you do one like that. The forward side is ground, the back side is hot, And I guess it could be different in other amps. I don't think so, but anyway. And I don't know that every amp you'll be able to get into, enough gap in there to get your iron in there to warm it up and flow the solder and get it out. If you can, it's going to be removing the whole board, and that's PIA. This was enough PIA. I wouldn't want to remove the whole board. So this is after what I did. Let's go back and look at that. I got, and I don't have any extra pieces cut, but I took a little piece of wire, maybe 16 gauge, 18 gauge, and stripped back a very little bit, eighth of an inch. And you can take the wire, hold it to the hole. It helps if you tin the end of the wire with some solder first. Hold it to the hole, put the point of your iron right here, warm it up, and the wire and this existing solder will get hot, start to flow, and the wire will pop right through. Then you can flow a little solder on this side, and then come on the back side and flow a little solder while you hold the wire. And that way you get a good solid connection on both sides. So, and for the next piece, next piece, next piece. So here you can see this is the center, and this is the ground on these new, where's my piece there? On these new panel mounts. That's your center conductor. And I'd use a file, like a rat tail file or something, and scratch that out and flow some solder to it before you try to solder the wires. It's going to be not good, because it's a thick, heavy metal versus the wire is very thin and will heat up quickly. This will not. So you scratch it with the file, flow some solder on it prior to. This is the ground tab. That's very thin, but I would still file that and flow some solder to it prior to. That way, when you're doing this right here, the solder will flow much easier, much quicker. So that's the ground right there. That's the hot right there. And you see the red on the threads. I put Loctite on there so it wouldn't back off and start coming out with vibration and what have you. And here you can see the left and right side. I did the same thing. There's your two positives here and here. If you remember, the top was on the right side of the board, and you can't really see it on this. But you've already soldered those wires through the board and have them standing up. You can, before you attach this plate, this front plate, you can solder, however you want to do it. Solder the wires before, solder it after. I kind of did both. I soldered some before and some after. And there's the ground right there, and there's the other ground right there. And that's the finished product, and it looks so much better. I think it's more durable, and it looks so much better. Now, here the amp is. That light's going to blind you. If you can see that right there, because they were so close together, right in there, that white plastic washer, which is an insulator, it's got a lip on it. So this connector, then the white washer with the lip towards the inside, that's going to sit inside the hole to insulate and keep it in place. Now the outside, all this outside is ground. It really doesn't need to be insulated, but it does keep it in place. So that beveled edge keeps it in the hole. I had to snip a little bit of the white washer. It was too close. They were catching on each other. So I snipped a little bit off of it so it would sit in there. So it doesn't look, it's not perfect. You can see that there, and I didn't quite get it lined up right there. It's a hair off. But still, It looks a lot better than these cheapy ones that were in there. Fits tighter. It's not going to wiggle. It's not going to crack on the solder board when you plug RCAs in and that sort of thing. So, hang on, and I'm going to plug this up and run a test on it. All right, she's plugged up. Everything's dialed in. And let's see what happens.
Lights. I ain't gotta worry on my mind. Know that you're mad. I realize that I don't need ya. I don't need ya. So did you say my name like it's my birthday? You're just a memory. I'm poor. I don't need ya. I don't need ya. Should've left your ass long time ago. Go ahead and love me good, but now I don't. Now I don't. But let the good things in my life rain down from the sky.
All right, so she's working, and don't know what I'll use that in, but there you go. You can put your Tiffany style RCAs on your existing amp. Don't know if it'll work for everyone, but some of them it will, and it's more durable, it's more attractive, and looks cool. So that's it. Have a good one.